Dear students, today in this video I am going to discuss about main economic thoughts of Gandhiji, in which first point is Sarvodaya. Gandhiji envisioned a society which uplifts the deprived, poor and marginalized people, and this idea was called Sarvodaya. Sarvodaya means upliftment of all. Gandhiji based the principle of Sarvodaya on mutual cooperation and love. For successful implementation of Sarvodaya, he presented the ideas of renunciation, service, reducing dependence on machinery, protection of labor, decentralization of power, and prevention of exploitation. Next point is importance of labor. Labor is the only living factor of production. So anyone who labors is entitled to live a dignified life. And there should be enough opportunities for all to work. Gandhiji asserted that though mental or intellectual labor was important for development, everybody should engage in some form of physical labor. He observed a decline in dignity and importance of physical labor in modern times, and thus he emphasized upon the idea that dedicated physical efforts to make a person to get employment and thus get freedom from poverty. Next point is use of machinery. Some critics called him an opponent of machines, but he was never against appropriate use of machines. The following points summarize his views regarding use of machines. First one is Gandhiji recommended greater use of basic and simple machines that can be owned by and useful to poor producers. Next point is, according to him, those machines which replaced labor and rendered laborers unemployed should not be used widely. Next point, Gandhiji did not oppose machines which are used for welfare of the poor. Next one is, machinery which reduces physical labor and saves time and funds can be widely employed. Next was that he was against the use of machines which led to concentration of economic powers in the hands of a few people and became a means of exploitation of the poor by a few profit-motivated rich people. He asserted that machines must not be used so widely that human beings become highly dependent on machines. Next point is decentralized economy. Gandhiji favored a decentralized economic system for India. He wanted economic power to be distributed among many Indians and not among a few people only. He wanted villages to get equal benefits of development, which can happen only through decentralized planning. He gave the idea of decentralized economic planning as an alternative to capitalist planning, and thus he promoted the idea of increasing the use of khadi and the idea of spinning khadi as a household industry. The concept of decentralized economic planning was rooted in the idea of Gram Swaraj. Now, next point is simplicity and non-possession. Gandhiji propagated the idea of non-possession and consumption for needs and not for greed. He advised people to restrict their wants and work towards contentment. He followed the principle of simple living and high thinking. He stated the following reasons for restlessness in human life: continuously increasing wants, use of complex machines, and distribution system of present times. Gandhiji stated that welfare increase when wants are limited. Real happiness lives in simple living. He insisted upon the idea of everyone's livelihood without anyone's exploitation. Thank you, students.